the whole issue is, can you serve more than one master? So if you are in an industry and you have a duty to serve your clients, and you also at the same time have a duty to serve your shareholders, can you do that? Is it possible to do that? We'll let Jack talk about that. The other thing that Joe raises, and I am definitely speaking from my own point of view here, I'll make an observation first, but right now, I was on a panel with Elliot Spitzer, of all people, and Wilbur Ross, and Wilbur Ross represented what is an anachronism today, and that is the notion a real asset owner, somebody who is investing their own money in the stock of enterprises, okay, so that he has the possibility that he will lose money every time he makes an investment, which is something that existed for partners when financial institutions were following a partnership model. Today, whether you are running an asset management firm or a brokerage firm, or you are running a corporation that receives money and uses the services of the financial system, everybody at the table is subject to an asymmetric reward system. Nobody has their own skin in the game. You come in, you're paid a salary, you're paid a bonus, and you have various deferred incentives which will increase in value if the stock, usually to which it ties, increases in value. But if not, you get your salary. Bottom line, no skin in the game, no downside. So you have people running mutual funds using broker-dealers to effectuate ownership positions in companies with everybody at the table being on an asymmetric reward system. Is it any surprise that the system overheats and has excesses at various points in time? Third point, and then I'll throw it over to Jack, is that at any given time, the financial services industry, and you're seeing this in law, and you're seeing it in accounting, and you're seeing it in medicine, is a combination to different degrees of professional business models and business models. Okay, so, and there are people or institutions interact with financial services firms as counterparties, as clients, and as customers, with different expectations as to what the obligations of the financial firms are. They're different to clients. They're more fiduciary-like than they are to counterparties. Fair standards of dealing and ethical business practices apply to all of those, but fiduciary is a higher standard than a market maker is held to entering into commercial transaction with a counterparty. But they're all mixed up and changing and evolving, and there isn't clarity on the part of people who use financial services firms as to what the protections and expectations should be of the people they're dealing with. And that's a problem in other businesses right now that are either on their way from being professions to becoming businesses or on their way from being businesses to becoming more professional.